John Popper versus Stevie Wonder.
I thought the conversation was who's the best harmonica player.
Yes, John Popper or Stevie Wonder. Stevie Wonder. It was those two.
Just those two?
Yeah. I was going to add Toots Tillman.
Yeah, Toots is definitely three after those two.
No, I'd say Stevie Wonder is three.
No.
Stevie Wonder's three with who else? Who's
you say Toots Tillman is better harmonica than us?
Yes.
Than Stevie Wonder?
Yes. Yes.
I don't think that Toots has as many classic solos as Stevie Wonder, though.
That's because Stevie Wonder is a pop star, and everybody knows those solos. Toots Tillman has taken way more solos on recordings.
Stevie Wonder is a genius, and the shit that he sings or the shit that he solos are the most hummable solos of all time.
I think we're talking about we're talking about not the hummable. So we're talking
all
about
of
best.
It. We're talking all of it. That's
I
all
still
of it.
Think Toots is better.
No way.
It's better. This is like just like fucking.
Toots has taken a billion
like fucking,
solos that nobody knows.
This is like fucking Prince playing regular drums and everybody saying it's like the best shit that's happened since sliced bread.
No way. Because Stevie Wonder does harmonica gigs or on other records.
That's 12 seconds. That's a 12-second clip of Prince, by the way.
Whatever.
And it was a lot of. It's some good hi-hat, though. You got to give it that.
No, the hi-hat was sloppy.
I agree with James about that drum thing. But
this
harmonica thing, I think no way. I think Toots Tillman.
Okay, then
like,
what do you think about John Popper? Then?
I think John Popper is really awesome, but not as good as either of them.
You can.
I think he's better.
I think he's got the most flash. He does the most flashy stuff.
I think that would make sense. Wonder's, that you would say.
I think Stevie Wonder's compositional skills are blurring your perception of his harmonica playing.
No way.
Yeah. We haven't said anything about his composition skills.
If they had to battle it out, like drummers or like sax players or whatever instrument, John Popper would fucking wipe their fucking.
No, they only win. He only solos over blueses. No way. Stevie Wonder is soloing over songs.
Sophisticated shit.
Yeah, Toots Tillman is doing standards.
Have you ever seen John Popper play live?
Yes, on the internet.
Yeah,
No.
Not in person.
I've seen Stevie Wonder play live.
Have you heard his shit with DJ Logic, John Popper?
No, I haven't heard it yet. No.
Oh, well, they better recognize.
Don't you bring no damn DJ Logic record on
All he could do was blues.
Have you heard John Popper over one chord, though?
It's still one chord.
Yo, you heard over one chord, though?
He switches keys all the time.
Yo, he's mobile as fuck.
And he does chromatic.
He has a chromatic fucking shit. He has a fucking vest with all
the tuning. I'm talking about the music he's made.
Yeah, it's better.
Whoa.
Does Stevie Wonder?
No, his harmonica. No.
You just changed the fucking.
You just
Stevie Wonder over Stevie Wonder songs.
No,
this is John Popper over John Popper songs, right?
You changed the whole subject.
I'm saying I think he's better. I think he's better.
Let's start talking about something that we weren't just talking about.
I think he's better.
We'll do that now. No, we're talking about the harmonica player.
Yeah.
I'm talking about his harmonica player.
No, you're not.
No.
You said, well, is the music better? No, we're not talking about
that. Reggie's getting his mic cut off for a second.
No, but I just think that.
Lies.
I just think that.
Reggie's lying.
Stevie Wonder, as far as harmonica playing, I feel that he's the best because he's the most memorable harmonica player out of all three of them, because you can remember things that he has played on all of his songs and other people's songs.
Because you know it.
Because a lot of people know it. Yeah, a lot of people. All over the world.
We're talking about
all over the world. No one else is going to hum a John Popper solo.
I don't feel like...
Kelly,
you can take the music out of the equation.
Dude, on the flip side, what if there's, and hypothetically speaking, if there's some dude who just said, I don't know anything about, I don't know many Stevie Wonder songs. I maybe heard one solo that I can't remember, but I know all John Popper stuff, so I think it's better. Do you think that's a logical argument?
I don't know.
Because that's what you're saying right now.
I don't know.
You're saying just because you know this more solos, that makes them better.
I'm saying universally speaking, I feel like that it speaks to a larger crowd. Therefore, I feel like it makes them, that's criteria to make them the best.
So because more people can hum solos that were played by Kurt Cobain than Danny Yatton or Joe Pass, then Kurt Cobain was a better guitar player than them. That's pretty much what you're saying.
Yeah, that's,
if we're applying the same dumb
logic.
Well,
I guess it's like, well, how is it dumb to say, you haven't even heard what I said yet.
Memorable.
I'm saying, like, if you like it better, how is liking it better not thinking they're better?
because
I like
are
it.
Two different
I
things.
Like it better. I think it. I like it technically better. You know what I mean? Like, I'm if you're talking about, do you get deep into the just their playing? I'm only talking about their playing. I like Stevie Wonder's technical harmonica playing better than I like John Popper's.
Yeah, agree to disagree.
That's right. That's what I'm saying. Well, y'all making it seem like I'm not talking about the same thing.
No, you're not talking about life. You're literally just proving the point. You're like,
yeah, exactly.
You're like, I think he's better just because I like him. Not really based on skill.
Yeah, you just said that, bro.
I'm saying, I like it. If you go like between John Coltrane or Wayne Shorter, they're both amazing. I like Wayne Shorter better. It's not dumb. It's not dumb.
Reggie, real quick.
I think Stevie Wonder's playing is better than John Popper's playing over any recording I've ever heard of either one of them playing.
Okay. Yeah.
I've heard lots of recordings of both of them playing.
It's not dumb.
And
logic,
I think Stevie
Reggie.
Wonder is better. That's what I'm saying. It's not, how is that dumb?
It's not dumb to say that because it's more universally acceptable or accepted or more well known that it makes it, I think that makes it better. I do think
Let me get this out here though. That's not what we're talking about. Maybe Gabe and I and all of us are not familiar with the guidelines of this question. So I'm going to start all over from the beginning and get across what Gabe and I are trying to say is what we are arguing, the point we've been arguing, because maybe we're not communicating well. We're talking about who is the best technical, proficient harmonica player. This doesn't have anything to do with his fucking songs you like or whose style you like playing. We're talking about who is better on fucking paper, who is more able-bodied, agile, better at the instrument. Like, who could outplay the other one? If they were all three of them are on a stage and they're playing back and forth and trading fours over five different types of music, who would fucking blow you away the most? And I'd say John Popper would be the one to do that. And it has nothing to do. Stevie Wonder is by far, by leaps and bounds, anything that the shit he farts out is cooler than those two other guys. But that doesn't make him the better harmonica player. That's what we're saying. Let me finish, Reggie. That's what we're talking about. We're not talking about the emotional side of it, which you continue to bring in and also change the parameters of this debate, which is fucking annoying. Now, your turn.
We're talking about emotion in the music.
No, we aren't.
I am.
You are. Yeah, you won't fucking shut up about it.
Wait,
that's why we're
technical.
That's why we're not
just
having
want
this.
You just want technical.
Yes, okay. The best one. That's what I think is best.
I think Jimi Hendrix is better at guitar than Joe Satriani. Now you go like Joe Satriani can blah, blah, blah. I don't think personally being faster isn't automatically make them better at the instrument to me. To me, just cuz John Popper would play a lot faster than Stevie Wonder does not mean to me that he's better at the instrument. That's what I'm saying.
Well, that's unfortunate. I thought we could have these discussions.
Because it's like,
but
we talk about like a piano prodigy.
Specific about everything.
We are being, that's what we're doing, right?
I mean, we are.
Isn't that what we're doing?
I thought it was just who's better. But
that's
now
what
you got to turn it
that's
into
what
a
I'm saying.
Philosophical thing. I think John Popper, I think if we also set up in a room with an audience of random people.
This sounds awesome.
And we let John Popper and Stevie Wonder stuff, not specific to the songs or video, we just played audio back for them of like their most shredding moments on harmonica. I bet you people would get more, and we had a by applause, who was better at playing harmonica, just without telling them who they were. I bet you the John Popper stuff would be... would always win.
Well, that's a bet.
I would love to see cold hard cash.
I mean, the thing you said earlier about if the three of them were on a stage and they all played a bunch of different songs together.
Okay.
Yeah. I still think Stevie Wonder would win.
That's what I think too.
That's what I'm saying.
I think John Popper would win. I think John Popper would blow him out of the water.
I don't misunderstand the parameters.
Would be really cool.
I don't misunderstand the parameters. I think he is better than John Popper.
I don't know. Yeah, I think we don't agree.
We don't have to agree.
No, we don't. We definitely don't.
Yeah, we don't have to agree.
I mean,
This happens to me all the time when it's talking to
people.
It's like we don't have to agree.
Yeah,
it's cool.
That's what I'm saying.
But I mean that's interesting because
I would definitely have him number one.
You know, I mean, John Popper he's
very good.
He's really good.
And saying you're the second best harmonica player to ever lived is still amazing.
That's got to be tough for Stevie.
Also, don't they play
whatever, right?
They play different kinds of harmonica shit too, by the way. Don't they? Don't they play like different styles? I know it kind of does, doesn't it?
Because it's a choice.
Don't
right?
they play
we
different
all get
kinds
to choose
of
how you play?
Well, no, I'm talking about the kind. I'm talking about the actual harmonicas.
Yeah. I mean, he can play. I'm sure Stevie Wonder can play all the harmonicas if he wants to.
He does play all the harmonicas.
But his deal is chromatic harmonica.
He doesn't just wear them all on
his
chest.
He plays chromatic harmonica like a... chromatic harmonica is just another instrument, like it's a saxophone or something like that with Stevie Wonder. Yeah, with John Popper, he lives and breathes harmonica 24/7.
I mean, Stevie Wonder played...
okay.
Stevie
let's,
Wonder
let's
played
pause,
like blues, regular blues harmonica
let's
in those early records.
Let's pause for a second. Let's just stop for a second.
It breathes harmonica.
Fucking John Popper, his life is harmonica. Stevie Wonder has pianos and keyboards, and he plays everything, dude. So he's got drum sets, all that shit. But
so
it's
different.
Not fair.
It's different.
Are you saying John Popper doesn't have a drum set in his house?
I'm just saying it's different. I'm saying that is the amount of devotion and... You know, John Popper is harmonica.
Now who's being emotional?
That's very emotional.
Yeah,
now who's
emotional.
Being emotional?
Lives
and breathes harmonica.
I'm being poetic.
Harmonicas
not emotional. Night. I've never owned a Blues Travel album. I have a shit ton of Stevie Wonder albums. Stevie Wonder is way cooler. But in a shred off on harmonica, yes. John Popper would destroy Stevie Wonder. I'm sorry.
No, all right. I would be there in the audience. I would be in the audience with a Stevie shirt on, and you'd be in the audience
I hope
with
that
John
happens.
Popper shirt on.
I hope that happens where we actually
I mean,
get
John
to see
Popper can't
like
play
that.
All these other instruments really well like Stevie Wonder.
I don't
Wonder,
care about that at
all.
But I want
to
see them
But
go
I don't
back
care either because
of,
that's not what the competition
song.
Is about.
I want them to go them to go back and forth on whichever song John Popper picks.
I've seen Stevie Wonder
no,
play
we should be
Giant Steps
songs.
On harmonica. I've seen him play Spain. Play Chicoria, Spain on harmonica. He'll play all.
Yeah, do that, Stevie.
I'm seeing that's what he does.
We're talking
about
Stevie.
That's what he's doing.
Talking about Stevie.
That's what he's done. Oh man.
Oh my god.
But
so go music.
Go
music. He said all serious. So go music. Well, it's going to be the official music of the Wash. Washington, D.C.
The Wash?
The Wash.
Are you trying to get that?
The new
way people call Washington, D.C.? You calling it the Wash?
Hey,
I never heard that.
Kelly's down with the Abreeves. Okay, Straw.
I'm way down with
the Abreeves. We're going to have to put that under review. I don't know if that's...
The Wash?
It's okay to say that.
Yo, the Wash.
For Washington, D.C.
Send us your opinions, people. What do you think about the Wash?
Yeah.
This weekend.
Is that okay?
In a couple weekends, I'm going to be hitting the Wash.
Okay, now it sounds like you're doing laundry.
Yeah. I was going to say it kind of sounds like taking a shower a little bit, too. Oh, I got to wash. I got to hit the wash.
All right. Well, maybe it's under review.
Fuck it. Yeah, we got to ask some people.
Well, either way, it's going to go-go music will be the official music of Washington, D.C.
If you say it enough times, it'll catch on.
I think so, too.
Yeah,
that's what I'm saying.
The official music of the Wash.
You guys are, like, just judging it so early.
It doesn't sound right, man. We just got to know.
That's because it's brand new.
It's brand new.
We're reacting. You're supposed to judge it.
We're reacting.
This is how I break new ground. Okay, so...
You're making culture right now.
Yeah, so, yeah.
Influencer.
Go-go music is the official music of... The Wash.
that's like some Aziz type of like abbreviating.
Aziz didn't come up with this. This is Kelly.
But this guy, he does a lot of
Aziz
shit.
Aziz-like.
Yeah, he's like, Aziz, when I saw him, he's like...
Kelly's heavily influenced by Aziz, I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's it. He's like, he was influenced by me, basically.
Oh, yeah. Like, give me the tails.
I'm older, so...
Instead of the deets.
I don't know. But, yeah, go-go music. What do you guys think? I mean, like, go-go music
about
is...
About time.
It is DC.
That is the
indigenous music.
Why do you think that go-go music never had like a, you know, like how Latin music came out like in the later half of the 2000s?
They
kind of
tried it.
You know?
They kind
of
tried it in the 90s. It just didn't catch.
Yeah, they tried it in the
80s
too.
Yeah, because a lot of New York songs have so many songs have go-go remixes.
Like doing the
butt. I mean, everybody does it, but those go-go remixes only live in DC.
Oh yeah, I mean
or Baltimore.
On the radio.
You
too,
go see,
I mean,
you go see
in those places.
You go see a good fucking go-go band. They're going in and out of these tunes.
They never stop playing.
And they're not
it's one song.
Not, it's just one fucking one set, one 45-minute song with all these songs in it.
It's a cool thing. It's a culture thing.
Chick Grease.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, they'll do it.
I mean, Miles Davis was trying super hard to like get that. I mean, he had all his songs pretty much from like 87 on all had go-go beats in it. Like crazy. His drummer was a go-go cat.
Yeah.
Ricky Wellman.
I think Overnight Scenario might be the only one to do it. And then Jill Scott. Jill Scott on her album, she put a go-go song on that album.
That one broke out.
Bam, 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 bam.
What's Overnight
Scenario? I don't know
scenario?
If that was... It's Love, but I don't know if that was ever...
it was a single.
3 in the morning at the Pancake House. 4 in the morning. You know what I'm talking about?
Oh,
we should play that. Pull that out.
Ozzy Osbourne.
Okay.
Parkinson's.
Oh.
He's 71.
I thought we already knew he was sick. Was I wrong about that?
He's always sick.
I thought he was always kind of sick.
I think maybe he might be admitting it. I don't know. I feel like I've seen his shakes, but I think that
me too.
Those shakes before were from years
alcohol.
Of alcoholism.
Yeah, yeah. Alcohol abuse.
Yeah, but now.
Well, damn. I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's unfortunate.
He's been releasing like a lot of music, though. He put out a record that with Post Malone that actually is kind of fire.
I thought it sounded kind of good, too. I was like, this. I saw it written down. I was like, that's kind of stupid sounding. But then you hear the beat, it goes like, oh, this kind of is like Ozzy's voice over some big,
I think
like,
it's
pop
samples.
Version of that shit.
I think it's samples or like a Black Sabbath song.
It sounds like a Black Sabbath song.
Yeah.
I mean, the whole song does.
I think he's just re-singing.
Oh, I didn't know that. I thought it was its own thing.
I mean, you know. No.
You think Ozzy wasn't there?
No, he's there.
Oh, okay.
No, he's there. Probably dead. He's probably hanging out, for sure. He also just put out a song with Elton John too recently, Ozzy Osbourne. So this, I can't. I don't know if that's gonna be any good.
I don't want to hear that.
We can listen to it.
But today,
yeah, right now.
Right now,
yeah, go for it, man.
Yeah, I'll go.
Which one is this? Is this the one with Elton John or the one with
Elton John and Ozzy together?
Okay,
skip the commercials.
Yeah,
you're gonna have to find the link. Is it actually a track, or do they just take a picture together?
No, it's a song. I saw them release it.
Is it just a boomerang? And you thought there was going to be sound because you clicked on it and it said sound off.
All right, you ready?
It's no sound. It's some
yeah, I'm ready.
Some DJ's fucking mashup.
Okay,
sounds like Elton John.
Classic
song
Elton
already.
John,
right here.
You think Elton John still plays the piano on these songs?
No.
Somebody else is playing piano, probably.
Look at you.
He ain't doing that.
I don't know.
Lord, how do
I was unprepared for fame. Then everybody knew my name.
That's no more heavy auto-tune.
Whoa.
It's all for you.
Weird. The auto-tune is weird. I thought that he sounded good.
I have traveled many miles. I've seen tears in
where the auto-tune makes it not sound like Ozzy anymore. It
sounds weird.
It
kind of still does.
There we go.
I don't hate this.
Sounds kind of like 80s Ozzy.
Yeah. He kind of sounds like this on that Post Malone song, too. It's like a ballad.
Yeah.
Big ballad, you know.
I don't hate that.
Wow,
is Elton John singing it later?
I think he's supposed to come in on the second verse. Can you?
I feel like we played a lot of it. It's get taken down.
He's been recording because I think we looked some of this up before, but he's been recording with Duff and
Duff McKagan,
McKagan and Chad Smith. Like,
oh, wow.
like they're on a lot of these songs.
Oh,
they little. Little super group there.
Yeah, they've been recording.
Got some chicken foot in there.
It's a chicken toe.
Chicken toe.
They've been recording and writing and
chicken tender.
And Ozzy and also I think Duff is also like really good.
Chicken wing?
Really good friends with Elton John.
Call him the drummer.
Duff is a cool dude. Well, there was a Elton John thing. Remember when everybody was like, hey, Axl Rose hates gay people, and he's like, I don't hate gay people. I'm going to do a duet with Elton John.
People do that. People keep doing that.
Eminem did that, too.
Eminem did the same shit.
Yeah, he was one of the first ones, and they did the thing where they, like,
they hold hands for a second.
They 69 to the pianos, grand pianos together, and it was like a black and white piano, like good and evil
or something.
Is
that what they call that?
I thought they were
scissoring.
They 69 the pianos, because this is my own term.
I see what you mean. Because,
you know, like, grand pianos.
They scissor
like,
the pianos.
They fit together. It's not scissoring because there's no V in there. This is like, I mean, it's 69ing.
But
there's
two
so.
Backs. It's like two backs, though.
It's a curvature.
It's the two butts.
It's like ass to ass.
It's butt
ass
to butt.
Ass. Yeah. But anyway, yeah. I think it's funny just to say 69 the pianos because one side of the bass side of the piano goes out longer than the treble side, so they kind of fit together. You could draw a 69 in any. I don't need to go into this.
Wow.
But they should do that. You should somehow get an overhead.
We need an overhead view of two pianos, a black one and a white one.
And just put the 69 on.
Okay, get yourself some tracing paper and draw yourself a 69.
I promise that in the links in this. In this episode, there will be my rendition of what a diagram of an overhead of a 69 piano.
Okay, I like that.
I promise that.
And that will
can't
be
wait to see it.
On. I'll put that on the Instagram as soon as that's done. Well, yeah. I appreciate that. Thank you.
Yes, thank you very
and
much.
And also, if I can find it, and yeah, if I can find that concert where they did that, that'd be perfect.
Yeah, if you can get that to me, ASAP.
I'll do that.
We had like a 3-minute show before we start.
I'll get it.
It's funny that you played that song, man. I decided 2 days ago that I hate New Jack Swing.
You're making horrible decisions right now.
I love that he's here.
You're making horrible decisions right now.
You're in the minority.
I was like, this is terrible. I hope I never hear this shit ever.
I support his
you're making horrible decisions right now.
Johnny Gill.
In your LaFace.
No, all that was terrible. Terrible music.
I loved it all. Bobby Brown, new edition.
I was like, no.
Fucking
Bobby Brown. Fucking Teddy Riley.
Teddy Riley. Terrible.
Belle Biv DeVoe.
We know that Tony doesn't like singing.
Tony does not
like any singing.
He
likes R&B, rock, no singing.
He just wants drums.
Tony likes drums and rapping.
That's all he wants.
Give me a boom pap.
Yeah, he like, I heard Johnny Gill. How come he wasn't rapping?
Yeah.
How come he wouldn't spin bars like Nas, though? You ever heard of Nas?
Have you heard Bobby Brown bars?
Man, Bobby Brown had some bars.
I actually like Morris Day, though. Is that weird?
No, you just saying
now you're going somewhere else.
You're saying all kinds of stupid shit.
Before New Jack Swing,
I was
like Prince.
We know what the music is, Tony.
I don't even know you anymore. You're not making any sense.
I'm talking to a room full of
this makes total Tony sense, though.
I knew that was a popular opinion. Nah. I knew that was.
Is the show started?
No.
Dun, dun, dun,
start
dun,
it. Let's start it.
Start it up.
Oh, I thought that was just going to be the beginning of him to say.
No, I was trying to give him a little. I'm just trying to fit in with you guys.
You're doing horribly.
I know.
I saw the headline today, and it said, Pearl Jam releases their funkiest song in years.
They're funky.
What?
Their funkiest song.
Where'd you see it?
Are we looking at Pearl Jam for the funk?
Is this on the Prince Forum?
Yeah, it was a retweet from the Prince Forum.
No, this is like Rolling Stone, Consequences Sound, whatever the fuck. It's one of them.
Okay. Pitchfork?
Today. Pitchfork. One today.
One of their
player?
Funkiest
okay,
songs.
Player.
Their funkiest song in years.
Okay, players shouting out.
Absolutely no.
Pearl Jam.
Okay, Africa.
Okay, Africa.
It's like they're really hitting these platforms.
Fox Soul.
They are doing it.
Their money is reaching other places.
They want it.
I appreciate that. So, funkiest song in years.
Hey, it is already.
This is weird.
This is not them, though. They're not playing this.
They hired
this
the Strokes.
This is not Pearl Jam.
They hired the Strokes.
They hired the Dust Brothers.
They hired Spoon.
Hired Beck.
Oh, yeah, you go. Spoon.
I'm not trying to see Eddie Vedder Dad dance right now.
No. You know he is. Was edited?
What's happening?
What's going on right here? Save your prediction.
Love is already. Rightful
comfort. Oh, no.
Dude, nobody asked for this shit.
Nobody.
Absolutely nobody.
Okay, that's enough, man.
That's enough of that.
Wow,
you
Callie.
Know what? I guess it is their funkiest song.
Thank you for keeping me informed. I got to say that much. I'm glad I know about this. Because if I were out someplace and people were talking about it and I couldn't add to it, you know, I'd be upset. But now I can.
Man, if you played that song.
God, you got
some of it. Don't forget.
You play that song for like 100 people, no one is going to say that was Pearl Jam. Like, is there, the guitar is like a clean Stratocaster.
James.
Yeah,
James,
but the.
James.
James. He's kind of doing a creep.
Yeah. Let me play a little bit more of it. Or just let me hear. I just need to hear some of the beginning of it. This is weird,
what
man.
Is he getting at in this?
I don't know.
It's kind of Talking Heads-like.
I was thinking that. I think I could have guessed that this is any better.
I would have thought this was Talking Heads.
That's the moment.
Save your prediction.
Endless equation.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, man. Son.
I love how you
always turn it down at that section.
Yeah, hear
you're
that
just like,
all.
No.
I'm like, no.
No, don't even go. I'm with James, man. I don't want to hear no
I'm
more of this.
Too many douche chill.
Save your prediction.
We're not about to hear these chords going. We're not about to sit through these chords at all.
Shit sucks.
He's just James. He's just trying to save his predictions.
That shit sucks ass.
You're not trying to say predictions.
I can't make eye contact with anybody in the room when this shit is playing.
You're not uncomfortable.
Trying to say predictions. So cringy.
Oh man. Oh my gosh. That's weird.
Why'd they do that?
Man.
Why'd they do that? Hey, man, that ain't cool.
Why'd they do that?
That's not, you know, that.
Where the
that
guitar is at?
That is not like a. That question is totally valid. Why'd they do this?
Why'd they do this?
I don't know, man.
Eddie Vedder, you somebody.
Is it
I'm about
just
to start
Eddie Vedder
around
the
stage.
Is that the deal?
It sounds like the dust. Yes, that's what it sounds like.
You know
to
what?
Me.
You know what? Let me look at the credits here if they haven't.
Eddie Vedder and like his nephew.
I mean, just
brothers.
that
nephew made
just
it on
like,
Logic.
Literally, the difference of like the hi-hat could make it sound more like Pearl Jam.
You know, this is what happens. This is what happens.
Tell me.
When you hire your engineer, you hire your engineer to be your producer. That's what happens.
Oh, he made it all?
Yeah, no, it's the producer. It's the engineer is the producer along with Pearl Jam. So they got.
Well, that doesn't mean that it's going to be like this.
No,
it's
it
just
does.
The fact
that's
that,
what I'm saying. I don't know what you're trying to say
now. I'm saying that it means that like that they're going to spend like a couple years on Pro Tools, like
no,
just
that's
hanging.
Not, no, that isn't. No, that's not
that.
That
can be. It could
that
be.
That has
it
nothing
can
to do
that.
With that because you can have the engineer and producer. That happens a lot.
Well, it's somebody's fault.
Yeah, it's always. I don't think it has anything to do with that. I think it's
I'm
just,
saying that there's an
the person that they got to do the record makes records that sound like this.
I gotta say,
and they did that on purpose.
I think
probably.
The indulgence. I think that's where the indulgence part comes in. But I mean, it's
well,
I don't know. It's kind of
indulging.
Weird.
They're just
you don't think it's
no Pearl Jamming out.
I think it's like in terms of like a 90s band updating their sound.
Yes, that's what I think
it's
too.
It's not like a home run, but it's not a swing and a miss.
Yeah,
it's like if horrible.
It's
like if the Maroon
really
5.
Oh, you guys like this song?
It's like
no.
If, no,
I'm
but
in between
we're
about it.
That.
Oh. It's, no, like it's no if, Dark Necessities.
It's like
Gabe think it sounds like a Chili Pepper song.
If it's like
a little bit, no, like they're trying to fuse their style from back in the day with like this updated thing.
It's
love
kind
this.
Of a Kiedis like cadence there.
I'm sorry, James.
I'm sorry.
Oh no,
I'm doing the mix.
It's all very strange.
It's like
me.
If you got the whatever like Maroon 5 or Red Hot Chili Peppers now production team to give that treatment to Pearl Jam. Go, we are going to make you. Like Super Bowl halftime ready,
man. It feels weird having a close mic snare.
It sounds
on
really
Pearl,
strange, man.
On a Pearl Jam
it's
song.
Like Tame Impala.
It really does sound like a track from Logic, though.
It does.
Like the
that's
whole
what
thing
I'm saying.
Does.
That's what I'm saying.
And it also, it's like Eddie Vedder was in some other band before Pearl Jam.
Yeah,
you know, it's like he was just like, yo, this is I've been trying to do this funky shit, because he joined because Pearl Jam had a different singer.
True.
You know what I mean? And he was they found him like doing
they
some covers. He was like he was doing covers.
They
or something
are, well,
somewhere.
They were auditioning singers. They were like a different band, and then that band split up, and then they were like, we need a singer, and I think he sent him a tape or something.
Well, you know, like maybe tape. He was always in a funk band. He's like, get my funk band back.
He was listening to the Chili Peppers all through the
80s. He was like, hell yeah. He was like, why would you sound like that?
What's insane?
What we doing
is,
out here on his holler? Dude,
they
trying
opened,
to sound like Fishbone.
They opened for the Chili Peppers in the 90s.
Who, the Pearl Jam?
Pearl Jam did.
See,
yeah.
There you go. That's what I think. Eddie Vedder was like, you see these
he
dudes
saw
on
them,
here?
He's
like,
they up there crushing it.
They up there killing it. We over here on this bullshit. We on this rock and roll.
You know, actually, and a weird connection with it all, the Chili Peppers' original drummer later on became the drummer for Pearl Jam in like the mid to later 90s?
Yeah.
Yeah, Jack Irons.
Jack Irons, that's right.
He's a bad motherfucker, too.
He's super, super killing. Shout out to Jack Irons, for sure.
And Pearl Jam, you know.
And Pearl Jam, you know, listen, I guess... They finally had to jam for once. This is the jam. This is the jam in Pearl Jam.
No.
They finally did it. They finally put the jam in Pearl Jam.
I had a news story.
Let's hear it.
Okay, this news story is about a naughty music teacher.
Uh-oh, naughty.
Hit me with it.
All right, so there's this dude.
Here we go.
Is that the teacher? Teacher
in California.
You already know.
California music teachers.
You already know what kind of glasses he's wearing.
60-year-old man. Actually, no glasses.
No glasses? Okay.
Okay, here we go. This is the headline. California music teacher, 60, filmed himself ejaculating into flutes and photographed his female students playing them to fulfill his sick sexual fantasies.
Wow.
That is
nasty, motherfucker.
Jeez.
He claimed,
but they didn't know that.
They didn't know he jizzed on him.
I mean, of course not.
So he was a
nasty motherfucker.
He was indicted for committing lewd acts against 5 girls under the age of 14. He's accused of ejaculating into flutes and making students play them to fulfill his sexual fantasies, and coercing a minor into child pornography. Well, this is the deal. The thing that counts as child pornography is the fact that if somebody takes a video of these kids playing the flute. They're, you know, playing a
jizz-infested flute.
Thank you. So that's no bueno. He's pleaded guilty, and so he reigns in custody. He's going to be going away, but they haven't had the trial yet. But yeah, man, he's a 6-year-old dude. Was in like the flute. He's like a world music type teacher, so he's one of these dudes. It's like a white dude that like is like looks like he'd be really super sympathetic.
That's
to
an
the,
extensive
to
flute.
The cause.
Some zen.
Well, they're like bamboo flute, so it's a straight flute with holes drilled in it, and like he just fucking comes in these flutes, and like so. There's the other thing. I don't know what end he was coming into because like
that's what I was thinking of. Like, does he take the photos of the flutes and jerk off later too?
Well, check this out. So the mouth, the end you put your mouth on is like really
small,
yeah, and it's like a thin slit, and you have to. That's where you're blowing through, and that's where the sound is coming from. So if he jerked off into the bottom of the flute where the sound came out, like it would have to drip all the way up to the mouth to actually get jizzy, or did he just ejaculate all over the flute and just kind of like smush it in there or something?
That sounds
that's my bad.
What
I think. I think he's nasty as hell.
Oh, you think he just?
I think he's filled. I think he's just filled it up. I bet you that flute barely plays.
Yeah,
I think just clogged up.
Do flutes have a? Do they have holes or have like buttons?
Well, no.
Like,
well, this like, is not. This isn't a metal flute.
These are
a
bamboo flute.
This is a bamboo
cheap ass shit.
Yeah.
Oh,
this is some Land of a Thousand Villages type of thing. Like
it's,
that.
It's also another thing that I probably wouldn't be caught doing in public.
This is almost more like a...
Along with corn dogs, I wouldn't be caught
you
in public.
It's a very phallic flute.
It's a phallic flute.
So, but Kelly would probably... You're more okay with the, like, Jethro Tull style flute.
Jethro
like,
Tull style
by
fine.
The side.
Regular flute.
Yeah, yeah.
Classical flute.
The classic
flute. It looks like you're holding a hot dog sub
that's the
thing,
real
to the
that's
side
the,
of your head.
I mean, the way he's holding his flute, he's pretty much cupping balls, too.
He is cupping, and, like, look at him.
Oh, that is. He's, like, putting it in. It's like the shake weight on that South Park thing where you, like, to speed it up, you put your finger in there, and it takes your pulse.
Yeah, he's definitely doing the...
That was on Comedy Central.
Oh, okay. Yeah, he's definitely doing, like, a southpaw stroke right there.
But anyway, so this wacko...
Southpaw stroke.
Whacked off in these things. But yeah, it's flutes and
that's when
weird drums, world music. You know. Here's some dude going fucking ham on one of these flutes.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
No.
Oh, man. This is
this guy
should
definitely
put,
going to jail.
Post this.
Yeah.
Man.
Yeah.
Should somebody should have called you nasty ass earlier.
Yo, I want that to be the artwork this week, to be honest with you. That's, I want that to be the artwork.
These
that's
days,
intense.
I don't even
people
think
just
he's
want
the actual creep, though.
Oh, yeah,
yeah.
Yeah.
That's
wait, that's
the actual
him?
Dude, yeah.
Oh, that's a heavy. Yo, that's, I mean, I'm sorry.
Heavy
shit.
Heavy
flow.
Yo, he's like, he's like Al DiMeola in that shit right now.
Yeah,
like, he's like,
oh my
he's
god,
like
don't worry, I'm
shit.
Saving this shit.
You know,
I'll save it.
Shout out to Al
DiMeola. I got it. Oh my god, this guy, he's like whole. Well, people, you're gonna have a really good surprise. Either whether it's the art for the episode or the fucking link is in there. Have at it. But yeah, this guy's a creep. He fucking sucks.
Yeah.
Yeah. Fuck this dude.
That's horrible that he would jizz into flutes.
But it's awesome.
He might also have a thin dick.
Dude, if this is, it's fucked up that it happened to kids, but if he jizzed in flutes and then got like his buddies to play them,
he might have a thin dick like that.
People
dude
just want to put their fluids all over shit these days.
I don't think his dick can be that dude thin.
What, who's the, who, Rob Schneider played the dude with the thin dick in that one movie. Remember?
What?
Remember he was,
Dude Bigelow?
Was it
no.
Dude, no, it was like one where he was just like, it's thin! And Lance Armstrong's is, I think, is the next one. I think that starts.
I'm over that, dude.
Yeah,
no, that's
well,
gonna be tight.
But the Tour de France one, that's like the shit you're talking about, though, because I feel like that shit is like, why the fuck are y'all even tripping?
Why is it illegal?
Because most of these people are like, they all weigh like literally 105 pounds. They have to ride these fucking little ass bikes, be super small.
They're made of skin and water.
They literally cannot eat for like 6 months to do the Tour de France. And then they're like, you can't use that cream, though. It's like, y'all need to
yeah,
chill
yeah, what
out
was the deal with that? Was it
blood doping. I feel like it should yeah be legal.
Was he, what, it, he wasn't
dude,
doing
please
injections
explain this, because
yeah,
it's weird.
What the
it's,
fuck are
it's
you talking
about?
Yeah.
Blood doping, so you are, when you're riding your bike for long, long distances, you get really, really, really tired. So yeah, what they were doing was
sense
going to places where it was really, really over-oxygenated blood, an over-oxygenated place,
yes,
or really low altitude places, like really high in mountains and shit, uh-huh, and they would ride the shit out of their bikes, and their blood would accommodate the stress. So then they would take the blood out, and then so when they got tired doing a race, they would put the blood, the extremely oxygenated blood, back into your body some other time. So that was called blood doping.
Say this okay, hold up.
So
hold
you have you your own super blood from working out in the mountains or whatever.
Yeah. The one that's producing more oxygen because it's a
yeah,
less oxygen-dense air.
Whatever you're looking for, yeah, because they have all types of races.
Yeah.
Depending on what
and
race
then you
you're
go to a
out
regular race that's at normal altitude.
And you have your own blood in a container and someone
on
might
the
IV
road
it someone or right before the race. You can IV or like in get like a transfusion essentially of your own blood that's like super blood.
It's like mutant blood.
Okay, that is not, that's not that's so much shit.
That's a lot. That's really crazy.
That's a lot
and
of,
should be legal. I think that's it's first
I
of all it's my
vibe.
It's my blood.
That's a vibe for real though.
That's a vibe.
That's a vibe. Like
blood doping is blood doping is a vibe.
Whoa,
into your system.
Okay, first of all, this is not even something you can cheat by, like steroids. You just like shoot into your taint or something like that,
or
where,
or your
or
leg,
your butt, or your leg. I don't know.
I thought that's where you find the taint.
Your
go on,
butt cheek.
But anyway, you like inject it yourself and all this stuff. You tell me you've literally got to go. You got to have somebody that is, dude. That is that's too much. That's
yeah,
too
no,
much.
It's like well, also
that's
it's like,
a little too much.
Honestly,
stuff.
It's like it's in a weird way. I think it's a weird way training and preparing for a race because like
yeah,
because like you said,
it's normal.
Like because like say he were going to do a fucking...
no. I understand what you're saying. Like it's like harder, but that's not what we're talking about. He's going working hard. What happens in that high altitude environment? Since there's less oxygen, your blood works harder, produces more. You've got this highly oxygenated, potent blood. They
we
pull
talked
that
about it already.
Out. You pull it out, and they put it back in.
I think
dude.
It's pretty smart.
It's smart,
and it doesn't seem like it. If, like to us, that sounds like a really crazy thing. But if
it's
you
an
were,
advantage.
But if you're an Olympic esque biker, you got some nurse. You got a nurse with you. You got your team with you. All that seems like
it's
something that'd be really
seems,
easy to do.
It seems like it could
weird
be dangerous,
science.
Though. Yeah, I don't think that's like.
If you're
going to
get
that,
they should let it rock. If you're
going to
get that Tour de France money,
they should have let that rock.
I would. If you're going to
get that Wheaties money,
if you're going to get that Wheaties
money,
Nike money. Listen, I think.
Makes sense to me.
I don't think they should be allowed to do that, but they definitely need to be way up front and specifically say, if you do this thing, if they never said anything about it. then and they found out you did it and were like, I don't think that's right.
See, that's why that's I don't
not
know
right. That's
okay,
wrong.
Hold on.
That's not cool.
Okay, so that's what happened.
Okay,
and
that's not
and
cool.
That's what they're going to talk about.
That's
not cool. Oh, yeah, they took away
they
all
took,
the stuff.
They took shit from the past with the new shit. They
years
like,
later.
Oh,
whoever,
years
okay, so
later.
You're saying that whoever got caught doing it fucked
lots
it up
of, lots
for
of them
everybody
got caught. Yeah,
what?
Yeah, one
was
guy got
getting
caught
by and not getting caught.
One guy got caught and snitched.
That
one of
sucks.
Lance Armstrong's best friend.
Snitched.
He was the second. He was never got first because Lance Armstrong was better than him. He was always second.
And he was
so he's and he's the guy that snitched.
But he was doing it too.
But then he said everybody was doing it, and then he said
he ruined it for everybody.
But
nobody
end,
needed to know about
but,
this.
But also in yeah. the end, in yeah. the end,
is that guy still alive?
Yeah.
Yeah. Of course.
Well, in the end, if all those bikers were all doing that,
yeah,
then he still fucking won those races because he didn't have an advantage.
That's the same argument for baseball.
Still, he's still really
that's
really
the
good.
Same
that's also the same argument for the deflated football thing and all that shit.
Nah, that's different because in baseball, if you have a pitcher who's juicing and then Mark McGwire hit his pitch, that's fair. If you have Greg Maddux is on steroids and he's throwing steroid 110 mile an hour fastballs,
yeah.
and then Mark McGwire hits it, I think that's fair.
That's fair.
I think that's fair. But you know, only one person did the ball. That was ridiculous.
But
I don't even know
if
that helps.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm kind of over that too because I would say like Tom Brady is a great. Fucking,
it's like
quarterback.
I don't think it was the ball. I think it. I don't think it was. The
it's
ball.
Really hard. It's really hard to
I think
prove.
I think it was the best fucking team at that. For
it wasn't
that
a close.
Time.
It wasn't even a close game
at that time. In that game, they were the best team.
Yeah, it was a close game.
And no one even knows if the ball thing. Does
get
that even matter?
It.
They were cheating though. They were cheating
really
by stealing
matter.
People's
there,
signals or whatever.
There are some cheats going on with there.
I still think they're incredible team.
But the Eagles beat them, and it was amazing.
Of course.
All
it
right.
was still,
you
it
can't
was definitely
be the best
still
team
great.
All the time. Speaking of football, though,
okay.
I've got some news from one of the greatest football players that's ever lived.
Oh, of course.
Is the guy one of the greatest running backs of all time?
This guy cannot be stopped.
You talking about Orange Juice?
I'm talking about
orange
the one.
Juicy.
The
orange
only.
Juice?
I'm talking about Nordberg. I'm talking about
Nordberg?
Nordberg.
Orenthal J. Simpson.
Hey, Twitter world, yours truly. Well, the restaurant's here.
Can we just
so
one
good.
More time?
Every
one
time.
More time. One more time, buddy. I love this.
Hey, Twitter world, yours truly. Well, the restaurants here in Las Vegas are open now, and I went out the other night, and it was nice seeing all the people out, some socializing. The restaurant I was in did a great job on the social distancing.
They dissed it from him for sure.
Yeah, they just saw you coming in, and they did not want to sit.
Nobody wanted to sit next to OJ.
There was only three of us, and looking around the restaurant, it was pretty much that way at all the tables, even the booths. Every other booth was empty. So I think as long as you do it that way and you honor these social distancings and take precautions, we can get back to some sense.
Thanks, OJ.
Yeah.
Let's not forget, though, it's still here. The virus is still here. Unfortunately. I think Texas may have opened in a way that, wasn't conducive to safety, judging by the number of new
just seeing these makes me want to play ball.
He's like a newscaster now.
Glad to see that
yes.
the restaurants are opening now.
Yeah.
I see NASCAR is doing, they're going to have, they're going to compete
today. He's moving through all
the
stuff, dude.
It's a Simpson report, bro.
I get a little bit of my news from OJ.
Look at some live sporting event. the guys were asking me, do I think that could work in football? I said, well, you got to realize that.
The guy, he goes on to give you, just inform you about.
Are the guys just people he drink with?
Okay, I've seen them in videos.
Just drunks that he hangs out with.
Who are these people going to dinner with OJ Simpson?
Whoa.
I don't know, but I wish it was me.
All right, rewind for a minute. Me too.
Just dudes in Vegas.
Just random dudes.
He plays golf a lot. They are they're all white dudes.
Yes.
OJ, I would never call you black.
They are, yeah, I know. Oh, God.
You OJ.
Thank you.
Brothers in arms.
His golfing buddies, and they go eat at, like, at the clubhouse and stuff.
Right.
And they're in, these guys are pretty ballsy. They're in his fucking Twitter updates, like, hanging out jovially with OJ Simpson.
Man. He does this shit every day.
They're living their best life. Dude, this is the crazy thing. At a time mm-hmm. now where, just thinking back, like O.J. Simpson is out playing golf, going to restaurants, living his best life. And most of the rest of us are stuck in our houses and can't even go out. Like, did we ever think there would be a time where O.J. Simpson would be the one with more freedom at the time?
He's like...
like, that is so fucking insane.
He's like, they tried to put me in jail, quarantine. They tried to keep me
in. They tried twice.
You know what? And
one time they got it.
And you know what? The main thing with O.J., though, it's fucked up.
That was my stuff, though.
That was my stuff.
I don't really see what the problem was, really.
Yeah, really. I feel like every time, though, he's always just trying to refute his shit.
Whatever it is.
Well, the first time, he was driving around in my car.
Actually, I'm sorry. He's not trying to refute it. I feel like every single time, he just wants to take credit for it. Like, at the end of every video, he just wants to go, like,
and I'm not in jail.
Or, like, just be like, don't forget, I can kill you if I wanted.
Innocent.
Like, well, I feel like...
You're at a restaurant.
I just feel like you would just throw that out there.
We should be friends. Or OJ I'll fucking out. Kill you.
Don't forget. Yeah.
Part of being at dinner with OJ is multiple knives on the table.
Multiple knives on the table. Like, I think he always reminds people at all times. He's like, don't forget, I can kill you.
Yeah.
He got the golfing gloves on?
Yeah. Yeah. Every time. Yeah, yeah.
I bet you those.
You know who didn't want to be friends?
two white golf gloves.
You know he kills it every time when he tries to do the gloves.
Kills is an understatement.
Yeah. At the table. You know he's.
Sadie loves my stuff.
I know every time he's always like, ha, ha, it doesn't fit. the whole
Oh, you know
table.
He makes that joke all the time.
You know the whole table starts breaking. A lot of amazing things are happening during this social distancing time. Richard Marx and Paul Stanley did a podcast together.
That is random as hell.
It's here. I have it.
Are you just going to put it on now?
No, I'm yeah. No. Yeah, now everyone.
Now we're going to relay the podcast to theirs.
So nobody cares about those two nerds.
Like, yeah, we're like hosting them. We're about to host their podcast on this podcast.
Paul
now
Stanley.
Check it out.
Come on, man.
Paul Stanley.
Come on, bro. Paul Stanley and who is it? What's the other guy?
Richard Marx.
Richard Marx. Oh, he's the guy.
Moms loved Richard Marx,
dude. That's Mom Rock. Who cares about either of these douches?
That's true. It's not Dad Rock. That's Mom Rock.
At this point, they're grandfather age.
James, everyone that you know.
They weren't even cool when they were young, but they weren't cool. Kiss was never cool. Richard Marx is never cool.
James, you know what happens to people that aren't cool, that get famous. They think they're cool, and then they still listen to him. And they want to listen to Paul Stanley talk about all his weird, you know, sayings that he says. And Richard Marx.
What do you mean sayings?
He has like very cliche sayings that I have his book. He always has.
What?
The amount of times you'll like bring up of whose book you have, it'll be most random shit.
Every musician, any musician, if you want to write a book, Kelly gonna buy that shirt.
Kelly's gonna buy it.
He don't care.
He'll be like, yeah, I'll talk to some Sonny Cher. Look, I was reading Cher's book the other day.
What is wrong with reading Cher's book?
Nothing wrong with it. It's just funny. You
will
if you had it. I'm gonna get it for you.
You would have it.
You would have it.
It's a Christmas gift.
Just haven't gotten it yet.
Probably great. I mean, she's
probably great.
She hung out with everybody. I mean,
I'm with you, man.
Greg Almond, you know, they had a relationship.
Greg Almond?
Greg Almond. Almond.
That's what I say.
Osmond and Almond.
Almond brothers.
Almond.
I want to coordinate a hangout with my dad and Kelly.
Oh, man.
Like, and just, like, hang out and play records for each other. Yeah. And talk about
classic Dad Rock
Dad.
Talking about Richard Marx.
Yeah, shit like that. No, my dad doesn't fuck with Richard Marx or Paul Stanley.
I'm not
going to
talk about Richard Marx.
He doesn't fuck with either of those guys. But he likes a lot of the stuff Kelly likes. A lot of the, you know.
I don't like Paul Stanley.
A lot of your music book library, he'd probably go, oh, I have this one too.
It's heavy.
I think Kiss was actually maybe cool for a second, but just for kids.
They were cool. No, before they were for kids, because before they had like all the action figures and shit,
yeah.
If you watch their
old
cool
for
shit,
a second, right?
When they first came out, they were cool. Because they had Rush.
It's just so tough.
They signed a couple of cool bands.
For like a couple, yeah. I mean, look, they found Van Halen.
They definitely, like...
They found Rush.
Also, this is the other thing. Because...
They did put a lot of bands
because
on.
Kiss were the ultimate, like, music business dudes. Like, it was all, hey, oh, these bands, we're going to bring them on tour and stuff, and we're going to take a little bit of, you know.
And they had,
Simmons and Paul Stanley, Gene Simmons mostly was like,
why are we doing this? Promoter, I don't know why we're doing this. But like, yeah, no, look, they've had some of the best managers, and actually their manager they have now, Doc McGee, who's like one of the most famous rock managers of all time, he was talking about all the opening acts that they had recently, and they hired Dave Garibaldi to open up, like, for some Kiss shows. Like, Dave Garibaldi from Tower of Power.
The drummer?
The drummer.
With his group? Just
with
alone?
With his group. Or it was either with his group or alone. Wow. But supposedly because he just has, like, a different kind of thing. He will... Yeah, that Kiss will get some really diverse, crazy shit to open up for them.
Well, I know more about Kiss stories than I do about them at all in their music, you know what I mean?
Right,
yeah.
Right.
I know that Kiss has something to do with Earth, Wind, and Fire's costumes. Like their costume, yes. The makeup designer, and all the theatrics from their show, they hooked up with one of those guys.
Yeah,
and
the same
got
dudes.
Their costumes and shit.
I mean, Dave Copperfield worked for them, so I mean,
there he goes.
Yeah, Dave Copperfield and a lot of other guys, Doug Henning, who also ended up working with Prince, and I mean, there's a couple guys, Roy Bennett, he's one of like the genius lighting directors who did like Prince's tours,
right.
And did Kiss, and Earth, Wind and Fire.
If you
same
went
people.
Back, if you went back and back, I don't know about Parliament stuff as far as how early their crazy theatrics go, but like with the fog machines,
they were competing
like,
with. They said like, Kiss too.
Okay, so because I don't know if Kiss was Kiss the first one that did the pyrotechnics and all that shit.
I think they were the first one to rent everybody has seen, like everybody heard of Kiss. You know?
Kiss, right. Kiss was definitely one of the first to use pyrotechnics.
And props. All that
Parliament
shit.
Were one of the first to like actually, well, no, I'll take that back. Actually, Earth, Wind, and Fire.
The ship would land.
Earth,
stuff.
Wind, and Fire was first, though, because they were doing the actually disappearing from the stage.
Yeah, they were doing
in, like,
they were
75.
Doing, they were doing shtick.
They were doing, yeah. They were doing straight up shtick. All American entertainment right here, boy.
The inside competition of touring, like, and like who can be the most extra between the crew of Kiss, Parliament, Rick James. And who's the other one?
Earth, Wind, and Fire
was
in there.
Earth, Wind, and Fire. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, it's basically a bunch of R&B and funk bands that saw one rock band.
Yeah.
Because all the other rock bands are kind of like, this is like kid stuff.
I feel like they were the only band that they thought was actually kind of cool.
What?
Like, you know, all the R&B bands are like, how the fuck they letting them look at their show?
Right.
What if our show looked like this, we would blow up too.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. They're like, these guys ain't even killing it. Like, we would be killing it.
That's what I think it was. They're like, they can't even play.
Yeah. I mean, they're going to all the shows. And the thing is, I think the difference is that, like, some of the guys were musicians, and some of the people were, like, straight-up entertainers,
right.
And they mixed all the shit together, and some were just better than others with that. You
absolutely.
Know, because the Jacksons would steal from Earth, Wind, and Fire. You know, Kiss would steal some of the best moments
from whoever.
I'm talking, you know,
full-on production.
Movie production.
Like, it was the, like, what has become, for an A-list act like Taylor Swift or Madonna or whoever, or Elton John.
Lady Gaga.
Where you go there, Lady Gaga, when you go to these concerts and there's props and catwalks and elevators and like screens and shit blowing up and torches and like 24 backup dancers.
Yeah.
Like that whole shit started with Kiss and these dudes running around with platform shoes and sparklers.
Oh, hell yeah.
Shooting out the guitars.
I think the biggest production concert that I ever saw in real life was MC Hammer. And it was the same back when I was in middle school.
Dude.
MC Hammer, there were so many explosions, dude. It was so many explosions. They had gigantic hammers. On the bottom of them was like big springs. So these hammers were like nailing and hammering all over the floor. There was like 20 people fucking doing the running man. It was crazy.
How many of those dudes have bionic knees at this point? Because I'm sure that whole show.
The hammer dance?
The hammer dance. But everybody is just bouncing. Like, I'm sure it's like every song is just,
bro.
Like, everyone's bouncing on the hardwood floor in my socks trying to do the hammer dance so many times.
Man.
Because it was like the time of cardio workout videos.
But those pants for that time,
parachute pants.
I don't think, I think because they were were so like
you could jump off a building. You could. And they were so floaty, fill up with air, and you could float to the ground.
Now
slowly,
you had pants gracefully. That look. You could see how you're dancing. You know now, like those pants, you could see actually the moves of dancing.
You know what?
If, for everyone,
if Vanilla Ice had been wearing those types of pants when Suge Knight was hanging them off the fucking balcony, it wouldn't have mattered. He'd go,
safer.
Go ahead, fuck off, Suge, and he would have let go, and he would have just floated to the ground.
Yeah. He would have lived.
Yeah, or you can go and try to find James and bother him while he's trying to run sound.
Well, where's he running sound at?
not on Saturday. Friday, it looks like it's a go. I'm mixing KRS-One on
the Blastmaster.
Nice.
What looks like to be a private event, I think.
That sounds great.
I got the call this week from somebody that I do just strictly mix gigs for. Like it's a company that provides backline and stuff. Like the same guys that did like the Wu-Tang show and shit that provides all their DJ touring stuff. But whatever. Killing. So anyway, he hit me up, and I worked obviously with KRS-One, and like the discussion goes, "Hey man, so like." You work with him, right?
You already know what it is.
And I was like, yeah, I did the gig. He goes, so man, like, he ain't hearing nothing, so we gotta make sure I bring the wedges that are loud enough. Like, it's like an actual concern, like, that's gonna be so loud, like, the front of house, like, it's louder than front of house sound, like, what's coming out from the monitors. But it's, you know, like, technology and sound.
You should get some inner ears.
I don't do that. Dude, that's not how KRS-One rolls.
You know he shouts that at
he
you
He yells all the time, and he has to have the track louder, as loud as his yelling through a microphone. But it's been like over, it's probably like almost 15 years since I did monitors for him. So there's been major advancements in technology since then. as far as, you know, within, like, equalization and various DSP processing.
Various processors.
Yeah, and things like that. And, yeah, just these really nice speakers now. They're smaller package, but very loud.
Are
you
going to bring some extra speakers just in case?
We're going
to wheel some out?
So I got another gig at a brewery before that. I'm just going straight there. And the head dude that owns all the shit is going to be there ringing out monitors and all that shit. So by the time I get there, everything will be great. And like, the room's gonna be packed out, but I think it's only like a 500 capacity room.
Wow. That's
great.
Oh,
that's fun.
Yeah, it'll be, well, whatever. I'm gonna get yelled at by KRS-One for sure. Multiple times. I'm gonna go into this and I know I'm going to get, people are gonna get mad at me. And it's like, whatever. You know,
You know what I would do? I would save one monitor. And don't set it up. You know, have him do the sound check and make it loud as fuck. And then once he starts complaining about, like, there's not enough, you can wheel out another speaker and you go like, we got another speaker for you.
The last thing he's going to want to do in his probably 25-minute long set is stop it so you can put more.
Oh, he just starts. He does no sound check. There's no sound check.
I'm assuming there's no sound check.
Okay, never mind.
I'm not showing up until, like, I'm not showing up there until 11 something. He's not going on until probably after 12:30.
Is this Friday? This is Friday night?
Yeah. Rap, like these showcase shows, like, don't have sound checks. They come in hot. They do the thing. DJ, usually the DJ just brings his vinyl or his Serato brain and a laptop and gear is backlined.
Yep.
Like, this is going to be, it's like a fly date thing because they got another, you know, the next day they got a real gig.
Can I go to this somehow?
I don't know.
You have
how.
A gig.
I can.
Okay. Well, afterwards. I mean,
oh, yeah. No,
this
we'll be done early.
He's talking about KRS is going to go on stage at 1 a.m.
Yeah.
Fire.
And it's and because I did one of these for, who's the beatbox dude?
Razzell?
Dougie Fresh.
Oh, yeah, Dougie Fresh.
I did one for him when all his friends got chicken grease all over my fucking cables. But
it's racist.
No, it
I'm
isn't.
Just joking. I'm just joking.
Wins everywhere, Kelly.
Typical.
So anyway, yeah, but that one, he came in like 1:30, did 20 minutes, and that was it.
Of course.
Yeah.
Yeah, can you get us in?
We'll see. I can show you where it is.
We'll text you.
And maybe you're on your own from there. But yeah.
if not, then I'm trying to make it to this exclusive.
I can tell you more about it after it's happened. But
that's cool.
Of the location, but off air. But
that's cool. I don't want to go. I've seen Kurt.
Well, I don't know, man. He's like, he talks about all that Illuminati stuff all the time, man. I don't want to cross him.
I want to see that.
I saw him in 96 before everyone was talking about that shit, so I'm good. But
when I found out, you talk about him like he's Batman.
History. His story. It's his story.
And he's a dark dude. He comes out at night. I don't want to cross him.
Yeah.
1 a.m.
That's terrible, man.
I haven't had the chance also to watch this. This is someone else doing a version of 1999.
Why?
What do you mean? What do you mean? Watch it.
Well, I haven't seen this. This is Coldplay.
Here we go.
They did a Tiny Desk concert.
Lay it on me.
I can't wait.
And they covered 1999.
They covered 1999 on their Tiny Desk concert.
Yes, they did.
That sounds like a Mad Lib.
Yeah, it's a little freaky. I have to. Bear with me because I do need to find it, but I am already like kind of cued into a certain area, so hopefully I can find this. I'm plugged in.
I always thought Coldplay.
You're already playing music.
I always thought Coldplay was like Radiohead. Like, is that not fair?
In the beginning, I thought they're Radiohead. Like, you know,
is that mean? Is that not fair?
There's gonna be somebody out there that gets offended by that. I don't doubt that at all.
How dare you compare?
Somebody listening to this is gonna be mad at you.
The God.
It's too late now.
No, I'm pro Radiohead.
Okay. No, I thought like of them like as being like them off shitty, a little bit. Shitty Radiohead, like commercialized.
Yeah, that's what I thought they were too.
Yeah, like Walmart Radiohead.
Exactly. That's what I thought they were.
What you got?
That's what he meant, folks.
That's what I mean. Oh man, we got some black people back
What's
there.
What's this?
So that's definitely not. That's
not 1999.
That's not 1999. It's gonna be after.
He has a choir with him.
He has a choir. He has a black choir with him. Of course.
Do they have robes on?
Yes. No. They're all just wearing black and some roses.
All those choirs need to charge extra if they want you to wear the robes. That's free game. You rock star want you a black choir.
Oh, here it is. Here it is. So this is the gospel. This is the gospel people singing it.
This is Coldplay.
And he's got a choir with him. Is that him making that voice?
No, that's him. These are all other black people singing the song.
That guy was kind of doing a Prince impression.
And one of those dudes actually sang with Michael Jackson, so he needs to get the fuck out of here, God. Personally, this is me.
So, what members of Coldplay are playing? Right?
Where's the drummer at?
They're all playing the music, but they.
I only hear piano and singing.
Yeah.
This shit is trash.
This is
weird. Yeah, what is garbage?
You know what? You know what this is? I'm gonna say it. Ripping off Kanye, doing a pop song with the black choir as your new music.
I think people do that for a while.
I don't know. This is very on the Tiny Desk concert.
I mean, they're on the Tiny Desk concert, but in general,
a famous band shows up and does the covers.
They'll be like some random Adam Sandler
movie wedding
from the 90s.
Band cover.
Yeah,
out of all songs.
Yeah, that's garbage right there.
They sound good, but why?
I don't. I mean,
oh no, it doesn't sound good.
No, Jay-Z
doesn't sound good.
It sounds okay.
It's just corny.
It's just garbage. A really clever idea.
They don't really need to do
exactly.
It.
Exactly. It's so clever.
They don't need to do it. You know, really. But yeah. I mean, I was waiting for it to be on YouTube.
Well,
so
they
I
sound
could,
good.
So I can play it on the thing. All right. let's see what else we got.
What's
here.
What's your favorite Coldplay song? None for
just
me.
Just that part.
I can't even name one.
I can't even name one. I know one of them was called Clocks because I've seen it online. But that's all I know.
I like Trouble, that song Trouble.
How's that go?
That was the No, it was the one that that had the piano. It starts with the piano. It's real slow.
It's like bing, 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 bing.
No, not that one. Not that
oh,
one.
Yeah, that's the
no,
one.
Everybody likes that one. Everybody likes that one. That's the X and
Y
record. Not that one.
Okay, was it like
no. No, not that one. It's the one that goes
I don't even know what you're talking
about. Is it that one does sound like some Radiohead
shit? One of the songs you're singing is from a commercial. That's how I know that.
I think every one of their songs is in a commercial.
I used to rule the world one. that one definitely is the Coldplay that's little, on all the commercials.
Back in the day, when I used to listen to
that Speed of Sound,
the early 2000s, I used to listen to Love Line with Dr. Drew and Adam Carolla.
Oh, yeah.
And that was their send-off music.
Oh yeah,
at the end of the night.
I think that's why I knew. It. That's why I knew that song. I think
that's why I knew it. That's why I knew it. That's the only reason I knew that shit, because that was the goddamn Love Line.
I've just been watching just loads and loads of Law and Order.
Oh yeah,
original recipe, old school season.
OG,
okay.
OG, which I mean, I'm sure y'all have heard the news lately. I posted about it. I sent it to y'all.
Yes,
they've tapped Chris Maloney.
Listen,
tis apt.
I want to give it. Maybe we should give it up.
For that.
I think we should give a round of applause for
give
Law
it
and
up
Order
for
real
bringing,
quick.
Bring it back for staying on TV.
Staying on TV, but not only that, they are fucking loyal. They will kill a person and bring him back.
Hell yeah,
they will bring him back.
Wolf is cool
or her, but they will do it. You know, they are a loyal, like such a huge franchise that Law and Order and Chris Maloney. I mean, I think it's. I just don't feel like it's ever been the same without him.
Well,
it definitely switched. I mean, yeah, they wasn't that originally, like Kim and, you know, Hargate, Mariska,
something like that.
They were co-stars. They're co-leads.
Yeah,
but when he left, she was definitely just became the lead.
And they just threw all of his problems like on her. Like she became
on Ice-T.
She became like an even worse parent. And
oh yeah,
like just
also
just poured everything on.
Can
her.
I just point out that Ice-T is the only male role on the show that is a detective. He's the only male detective in the whole
right now.
Because
what was?
Oh
yeah,
they have the new guy. They got the new Middle Eastern guy.
I hope he becomes a permanent member. But
he's not official yet.
But he's not official. He works
in a different department.
He's more like a...
He hasn't made it to the opening credits yet.
Yeah, no. Yes.
He's a Jimmy Olsen of the show or something?
No, he's just an adjunct.
Okay.
Like, you know.
She's been promoted?
She's the captain.
She's the captain.
Okay.
She rules the department and her fucking shitty child rearing.
That's not really in the show this season, though.
Yeah, I'm very thankful.
Yeah, I'm
that
happy
too.
About
Which
that.
Which one? What's in the show?
Olivia's kid is not has.
Oh,
this,
the little gay boy.
I would say this whole season is
the little Nancy.
He's gay too.
He's definitely gay. He quit baseball. Got dance classes, and foreshadowing.
Why is Ice-T's kid gay and her kid gay?
It's fine. They could both be gay
because you can't have straight kids on a sex crime show because straight kids may not get victimized as easy as a gay kid. So in future episodes, you can have the gay kid. Like get a hate crime. Look at Ice-T's son. Like his boyfriend, like was killed or he's beaten and almost killed.
Yeah.
So it like it just opens up new because if it's not a daughter, you know, because obviously that's an easy victim for SVU.
Right.
If it's a guy, it's got to be a guy that becomes trans or a guy that is gay.
Or on the DL.
Or something. There's got to be something up that can be, that somebody can, you know.
They need to change things up because, like I said, I've been watching the old one for the 90s and everything. And that was complete opposite. It's super male dominated.
Yeah.
The only woman in it is usually just an assistant district attorney.
One of the lawyers.
Joe Hennessy.
And it's never the district attorney. It's the ADA usually.
Yeah, they were all like the same.
But they didn't have any female detectives until
at all.
SVU came along.
Yep, well, that was the first one.
Well, that's like the thing now. You know.
It's not the thing now. You're supposed to have more than one thing.
It's a thing now.
Yeah, but now there's only one male detective. I'm not complaining.
You sound like you're complaining.
I know, but I'm not doing it now. I'm preemptively saying Reggie. It's okay.
Don't call my name. Don't say my name.
Reggie.
What do you mean, Reggie?
Don't say my name.
Now, Reggie.
Reggie, I don't know what you're talking about.
Now.
Destiny's Child, calm down.
Now. Wow.
Whoa.
Okay. sorry, I have to bend my knee a little bit.
But I got to say this, though. I'm not going to believe Maloney's coming back until I see a commercial for it. Because 2 years ago they said Ice-T was getting his own show, the hate crime show, and that never happened.
Oh really?
I don't think that was a real thing. I think that was a message board thing.
They had the whole interview and everything with him and everything. They confirmed that he was going to do it.
Oh,
it's the same thing that's going on now, with Maloney.
Maybe it's the same show.
Oh yeah, I hate crime.
Dude, I'm glad you did this. Yeah, I know.
I hate crime.
I know he's like. That's perfect that you made a hate crime unit for me because I hate crime.
Well,
I'm sure he would say that.
No,
it'd be perfect.
No, Detective Tutuola, it's hate crimes. He goes, I know, I hate crimes too.
I know because I hate crime. They give me a whole unit. shout out to Chris Maloney though, because he is that dude, and you know, I like him when he's funny, but his serious shit, I mean, I feel like that it's so intense. Like, he is that dude. He's Stabler.
So good. He's Unstabler. I want to see him punch a hole through a wall and then cry.
I gotta say, like,
he's good at that.
I gotta say the strong and vulnerable. The how much he hates sex crimes gets girls so hot. I've heard some girls talk about Chris Maloney like,
really? Because if you think about it, that's like the ultimate like male like provider thing. He's taking care of the children of the offspring.
Maloney's got a butt too.
All right. Well, you said that.
I said it, people.
See, you know,
she's off the rails.
My problem is that every single time that he gets like super intense, I always look at his like hairline because it's so,
so
distinctive. Though
yeah, it's like its own, it's like it's a mountain range.
It's like
that shit right here.
Like how? But yeah, because like even like remember Phil Collins shit where it was like that too, where it just looked like some kind
an
of
oasis.
Yes, it looked like a beach, like a beach island. Scene.
It's it's a receding hairline that is.
But it's
fine.
It's sexy receded.
Yeah.
Sexually receded.
Well, sections are receding.
But unlike Phil Collins, Phil Collins is no Christopher Maloney. I mean, he definitely not. He works out.
Like, he was just the
Phil Collins, he's
an OG. You know, and shout out to Sting too because he did wonders with his hairline for real.
Yeah,
because he always looked like he
put a lot of money
back
into that.
He kept it going.
But Sting can afford any kind.
I mean,
of
like
street
I'm
hair
just saying, like
supplement.
What especially when what do you hate the most? And it's like creepy fucking dudes. And there's a show where Maloney
just kicks the shit out of creepy dudes.
Yeah.
All day.
And everybody's like, yeah.
He's choking him out, throwing him against the glass.
He gets the fucking macho alpha male pass because he uses his powers
for good
against these chomos.
I love when he slaps the table up in the air. He's like, what do you want? Like slaps the table up off the like, pushes
well,
him against
just
the like,
hold up a minute, because I gotta say, there have been a couple of times where like it'll be like him and Benson like just yelling at some dude like, huh, what happened? You couldn't get it up, huh? Like, you know, what's wrong? Your little ass dick. You probably couldn't get it up. Probably couldn't finish if you got it hard. And then like Craig will come in and be like,
hey, come on, come here.
And then like he'll come out and be like, that's not the guy, it was not his DNA. And they're like, when they just move on,
Chris Maloney goes there and punch the guy in the face.
They don't apologize. They just go back
to
the investigation.
Yeah. Yo.
This guy had to pay for years of therapy because of it, because he had all those problems, but just wasn't a rapist.
The first few years of the show, they did not give a fuck.
That was the good years.
That was the really
best
good years.
Year.
Yeah. Olivia was getting kidnapped. Yeah. They were shooting people. It was hype.
Yep.
She started out the show hooking up with one of the other detectives.
With the insurance commercial.
The insurance guy.
With Mayhem.
Yeah, Mayhem.
Oh,
what's
man
up, dummy?
I don't remember that. Wow,
dude, those first the Maloney years are the best years.
Totally,
for sure.
They were. He should definitely be back.
I liked it when the whole cast was there. When it was Maloney was there, and Ice-T, and Richard Belzer,
Richard Belzer,
and like when all of them were people started leaving.
BD Wong.
Go get BD, and of course Casey Novak.
Fucking Casey Novak, my favorite district ADA.
The best
on the
one.
Whole of all. All of the fucking
agreed.
Barb was a close second.
All of the Law and Orders. I love her,
man.
She was doing all kinds of like sting operations and shit. She was awesome.
That was a great like kind of dream team ish with Ice-T and Richard Belzer, and like they all would joke with each other all the time.
Yes.
I mean, Ice-T having a partner is great.
They never brought another Belzer character back, and I wish they had.
Yeah.
The show in
you
my,
need your I, old conspiracy.
Yeah, the show
conspiracy
got a little. It got a little too serious.
Divorcee.
Yeah.
They got a little too serious. You know what I mean?
Man.
And, like, having Belzer there made it the best.
That's what I'm saying. There's no There's no, I don't want to say comic relief, but there's nothing to lighten it up.
Make fun of the president. Always, make fun of the government.
Or like Rollins has like real problems in her family. His shit.
Yeah, Ice-T has some one-liners. He has some zingers.
Ice-T, but he's all we've gotten. We need more than just Ice-T. It can't be, like, by now he's learned things, and we can't just have the bit of Ice-T going, oh, so you're saying it's
he's
like
great.
When mama,
he's
mama,
I think he's. I think he's kind of supposed to be the new old Jew in the group, but, you know.
Yeah, the divorcee type.
Yeah. Well, he's a weathered cop.
But either way, he is one of the best, like, straight men, like, for, you know, for the comedian, yeah. Like, you know what I'm saying, the chemistry.
Yeah.
He knows how to do that shit, the trade-off.
Yeah,
he's really good with that.
They need him, though. They need another guy to be like Bells and let Ice-T be the straight man.
At the beginning, you know? When he was...
Guy, that's the thing. This new guy they're bringing in, I like him, but he's not that person.
No.
Yeah.
But they should still bring him in. He's still good. But they need somebody else that can just.
Yeah, good thing you said that one time, because I think if that, because obviously I think they're hinting that Rollins and him are going to be a couple, you know. Uh-huh. Mm. But I think it'd be fucking funny if he came in and just started dating the young girl.
Oh
on
yeah,
the Latino girl.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
What is her
Latina
name?
Cat.
Cat. Yeah.
Mm. What is she?
I don't know if she's. Oh, yeah. I don't know. She's brown, but I'm not sure.
I don't know.
Well, anyway, whatever. So. She, yeah,
she's a boxer.
I think it would be great.
She's a boxer.
I think it would be great if he went in after her, because Rollins is like older than him, I think.
Definitely.
Yeah, she got kids and stuff.
Yeah, and then Carisi just wants to wife her up.
It's true, man. It's like that's the only thing about the show that I thought was bad. Without Chris Maloney there.
Yeah,
it just made it so they redid the thing. So now, like, they made Rollins Olivia, and now she's got this kid. You know how Olivia was just a badass cop,
right.
And then she has this kid, and now things change.
No, that's what I meant.
And then they redid it. They did it with the Rollins again,
right?
You know, like, oh, now she has a kid.
Yeah,
and her partner.
Well,
suffering.
She also has the shitty family, which Olivia used to be her brother, and finding and her mom's.
Yep.
Suicide and finding out about her father and all that shit.
And then her dad came back and he was a criminal or somebody in her family.
Her dad was a rapist.
Yeah, and then just brought it back. No, not, I mean, Rollins' dad.
Oh, Rollins. Oh, yeah, he was a drug addict.
Yeah, and then he fucked their shit up. It's like, it's kind of the same story.
He's a piece of trash.
I mean, how many stories? How many stories can you have? I mean,
I wish that they would bail on all those. Mm-hmm. Just have the cases.
Yeah,
bail on their family life. Almost nobody cares about any of the characters' family lives.
I mean, it's gotta be tough. You're doing like 15 episodes a season and like trying to come up with fucking stories for every single one of them.
Come on, man, it's mad crime.
It's a lot of crimes.
Yeah. I think we go back to that original cast. I think they're you know, their personal lives, like how much they involved it in the stories was just the right amount. Mm-hmm. But also everybody's agenda, everybody had their own motives and agenda. Everybody had different backgrounds because, like, at least, you know, Stabler and Benson, you have one, you have a man with a wife and kids.
Yeah.
Like four, right? I think it's like four.
Yeah.
And then they're
Catholics. They don't stop having babies.
Yeah. And then you have, you know, Benson, who's like, you know, she's single and young and, you know, ouchier. Mm-hmm.
Ouchier,
you know?
Dating.
And you got Richard Belzer's divorce and everything and never had a kid.
Yeah.
And then you have, Ice-T, you know, he's just getting some on the side, but
he's
like, the son doesn't come around until way later.
Yo, was he fucking that reporter? Was it implied?
It was implied.
But was he, do you think he was in the show?
Fan fiction wise, I don't know. They never said it.
You know, he was fucking.
I assume that she did.
Hot reporter?
Oh, yeah.
I assume that.
I hope so.
Yeah. You know, he's laying that shit.
That's
down.
It.
We've laid it out. We can move on.
No. I'm not done. I'm not done with this.
You know what? Oh. These are their stories. Can suck my dick because I love talking about this.
We did a
fantastic job.
Deep dive into Law and Order. Go ahead.
I think the new season of Law and Order should. They made it so all the characters are too clever. Like they need a cop that's not clever and isn't trying to be funny. Like Christopher Maloney wasn't ever trying to be funny.
He wasn't
ever trying to like one up them. Like, and I bet this is the blah blah blah. Oh, you know the blah blah blah. Well, the no, blah blah blah. Like
he's a
some
simple
joke.
Guy.
The only time he smiled was when he was about to punch you in the face.
Yeah, they need
the only time
that was
the only time he tried to be funny is when he's trying to scare the shit out of you.
Yeah, that's right,
Reggie. That's also why I liked Olivia's boyfriend at the beginning. Mayhem.
Yeah,
dude.
He was good for that
because
reason, too.
Because he was a fucking dummy.
He was just a... He's like, I am a narcotics cop.
And he wasn't a bad dude.
You think anything out there for you?
But he quit. He quit sex crimes because it was too fucked up, and then he did undercover shit and Vice stuff. But
he was like,
that guy was great. He was like a dumb meathead. And
they need a guy like that on the staff.
Fucking up.
They need one of those guys.
I was undercover, Liv. I got to do what I got to do.
He's like hanging with hookers and shit.
Oh, there was that one time where he was undercover as like a pretty much a dirty cop. And like, I don't even know. This is while they were dating. But like, he had to go undercover as a dirty cop. And she kind of like had to, he had a wire on the whole time or something like that. And she had to listen to him, like, I guess it was like an initiation for these shitty cops. They got to bang a hooker.
But he doesn't fuck her, though. That's the thing. Like,
I think he does.
No, I think he actually didn't fuck her, and he ends up, like, making out with her and then just taking her into the room to fuck her, and then just talks to her and is like, hey, man, I don't want to do this because I got, like, herpes.
No,
because
listen,
so,
James Bakey one... fucked her, he would have said it. He knows when the fuck is going down. Whether
well,
we know it or not.
I think,
dude, because the guy would. I don't think.
I heard
so.
The radio. It was on
so.
The radio.
You heard, I think I remember because Olivia like stopped listening and like he actually didn't.
To be
and that was one of the things. One of the hookers thought he was like, "What's up with this weirdo? He doesn't want to fuck. Like, gay or something?" He's
I
like,
feel like I saw his episode recently.
No,
I
got,
and they banged.
I think he tried to say
this is a hilarious.
I think they banged at a later episode when he was working for that other guy when he was on CI.
He was definitely banging hookers then.
Well, yeah, on CI when he was the bodyguard for the pimp dude.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah.
All right. I don't know the answer to that. That is hilarious.
I don't,
back
know,
forth
I don't
right
think, because I think
it's
you
like,
would have
no,
bragged.
Did. No, you didn't. No,
you would have bragged about really fucking that chick.
No, because he was dating Liv at the time. I don't he, remember he didn't
no,
brag.
But
he
the
was
character
like, he was like, Liv, I was undercover. I couldn't break my cover.
Yeah. And
okay, he couldn't break that
no,
cover.
I, yeah.
Break that condom, though.
I think that's right, though.
What?
I think he didn't.
No, he didn't. And that, I think, is part of what blew his cover
so.
In the operation, because he, like,
he didn't
and
blow
Liv
his load.
Didn't know that because she, like, stopped listening, you know, obviously.
Man, I wish there was some easy way to look.
Don't to say look blew his up. Cover. Nobody got blown.
Woo!
Oh, oh, buddy!
Hey there now.
All right. That was a nice Law & Order deep dive there.
All right. Season one. Let's start from the beginning.
All right. Beautiful deep dive into the
Law and Order world,
the
man.
Law and Order world, the waters of Law and Order. Enjoy.
If we're talking drummers for a second, man, we gotta do some Mad Ups.
Ooh, do we?
Mad Ooh. Big Ups.
Do
fucking we never Neil talked Peart. About Neil Peart?
Oh,
Neil Peart.
Neil.
Yeah.
Neil. R.I.P. Before.
The greatest Neil. Drummer, and I think created of the music culture, the music store drummer culture.
Woo!
Like,
unintentional,
at least one,
unintentionally
it wasn't his
created.
Fault.
Wasn't
you know,
his
yeah.
fault.
His fault, but he was the one that they grabbed onto forever.
Yeah,
and like every all of that type of drummer all kind of sound like
I'm, can,
from
can
that
I,
point on.
Can I play a little bit under the?
Yeah, do it.
Should we not play Tom Sawyer? Because I've seen people just be like, "Can you guys know any other songs of Tom Sawyer?"
No, don't do Tom Sawyer. Do one of the other ones.
YYZ. Oh, that's my shit. Yeah, Spirit
or
Radio.
That one, or do that, or do Free Will, or do one of the...
Yeah, we're definitely going to play Tom Sawyer at the Brassman Show on Saturday.
Yeah,
because we haven't played that in a long-ass time.
Yeah, that, y'all crushed that
I like
shit.
That version, too.
Yeah, he's...
Mad
cool.
Big Ups, though,
Mad
for real.
Ups. And, you know, one real quick thing.
I'm playing it, yeah.
You know, people need to shut the fuck up. And I've had an enough right here.
Okay. Hold on.
Yo, thank you. You know, if Neil Peart read some Ayn Rand stuff in the 70s and, like, said he was into some philosophy book or something like that, and you, for some reason, think that's hate speech now or whatever or something, and you're, like, basically like Neil Peart is a piece of shit, which
not.
I have seen on the internet is insane.
No,
he was
yes,
not. He was a nice guy.
I've seen this directly from people that I'm, like, friends of friends with.
Unfollow them.
And so, like, pretty much them being equating that one guy is like, yeah, well, you know, I used to listen to certain country artists, then I found out they were, like, involved in the KKK, so I don't listen to them. It's like, whoa, wait a minute.
No, that's
like,
not the same as reading a book at all.
Yeah, I know. And also, let's just be honest, like... that stuff is not that extreme. Like, it's not that crazy.
And you knew
it's like, it's just some, like, conservative-leaning shit. It's not... Anyway, you know, I'm not even here to get into that. I don't care if he was reading Mein Kampf. Like, he was a cool guy. He was a nice dude. He was not the annoying music store drummer that he is not the fan of Rush that you might hate. He's just the guy that liked riding his motorcycle around. He liked playing drums. Also, before he died, he lost his wife and his daughter.
At almost within like a year. Yeah.
Within a year of each other.
Crazy.
He's
a musical, lyrical genius, really. I mean, like, the dude planned out every fucking note that he wanted to play.
You know, I'm a dick, and I'm mean and say mean stuff about dead people all the time, but, like, the same people being a fucking dick to him are the same ones that the other thing they posted is, like, Trump made a retarded person fucking gesture, and he's a fucking deplorable human being. It's like, if you spend all the rest of your time, like, poking and prodding at everybody, like, don't you see there's, like, a parallel, like, between all this?
Hot take. Wow.
Yeah, and it's like, also another thing, if you don't like Rush lyrics, like, don't criticize them if you openly love pop punk and you're a fucking adult. like you're a 40-year-old and you fucking Stolzy love pop punk. Ooh, you know, like all this. these little fucking, I'm so sick of this shit.
I agree.
So sick of it. Like, it is not worth anybody's time, all this fucking garbage for everybody. Like, listen, these guys are having a fucking awesome time.
And there's only three of them. Only three.
And if you don't like it for whatever reason, like, I don't know if you have some baggage, like, because they're, like, good at what they do or have some discipline or, like, your stepdad listened to them and you fucking hate them. That's not my fucking problem.
Preach.
Neil Peart was a good guy. His drum video is, like, one of the most techie instructional videos. Like, he's, like, sitting on his back porch with a drum pad talking about drums and playing the whole time. And, like, nice guy, man. Coolest guy in the band.
And you know what? The video, there's a video of him having dinner with the two other guys in Rush. It's, like, an extra, I think, of their documentary.
Uh-huh.
He was, like, just... He was the third guy that was added to the band, you know, after the first guy
left.
He was not the original drummer. And he still seems like he's the new guy. They talk about that. Like, when he's sitting at the dinner with those two guys, he's just, most of the time, he's not even making jokes. He's laughing his face off. Like, half the time, you think he's just going to, like, choke on his food, for real. Because he was laughing so hard.
Should have been Lars.
You know, they
had... Yeah, I saw that one online, too.
You know, they did that one...
Fucked up!
Rush...
so fucked up,
Rush did this one tour where... because they weren't using amp stacks anymore. They had ISO booths and all this stuff. They didn't need an amp stack, but they're like, hey, we don't have amps behind us on stage. We need something to put back there. So they put a bunch of rotisserie ovens and cooked chickens the whole show. And at the end of the show, they pull the chicken racks off, and after the crew, the local crew and shit gets done, like, packing it up, they let them all eat chicken and stuff and, like, take them whole roasted chickens.
Banging.
That's fucking cool.
Yeah, they're cool. Man.
Yeah,
keep your Rush landing to yourself. No one's impressed.
Ain't nobody trying.
No one's impressed. It's become like a meme, I think. Like, ooh, Rush. No one's impressed.
Yeah.
Shoot, is worse.
You know what? I'll say that about snarkiness in general.
Okay.
Like, if there's some band that you don't like, no one's impressed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
No one's impressed by you not liking something.
Yeah,
so who cares?
Can definitely make fun of something you listen to.
Anything you listen to, I'm sure we can make fun of it.
Yeah.
Because that's how art is. You like what you like, you don't like.
And also,
like, chances
are you've not put as much positivity into the world as the person that you are criticizing. And
go.
I'll say
look
that.
At 2020
I'll
James.
Say that,
look
I'll
at 2020
listen,
James.
Matt,
I like it.
I'll
like
say
it.
That, like, me talking about Anthony Bourdain being a piece of shit because he killed himself and had the best job ever, like, whatever.
Oh, never mind. We tried to give James a big up, and he couldn't take the compliment.
Yeah, you know,
he had to say something terrible.
No, but I'm saying, you know, that is what it is. I'm not saying to be perfect. I'm saying I'm far from it.
Anyways, all right, another Florida story. Florida man threatens to destroy a town with his army of turtles.
Oh, that's great.
Warning police that they never should have fucked with the saint.
Ooh, the what? The saint?
The saint, ooh! as he's arrested for shouting obscenities in the street.
What?
So this is in Indian Atlantic, Florida. I have never heard.
Indian Atlantic?
Indian Atlantic, Florida.
You think this guy just, like, really loves Ninja Turtles?
This is Splinter.
He's an older gentleman.
This obviously has to be in one of the trashier parts of Florida, like on
you
the
calling turtles trash.
Or he might not be older. He might just
right,
be
because
he's
he got 61 turtles?
Years old.
Oh, he is older.
He's 61 years old. If you look at the picture, you can tell he is old. And he looks 61. He looks older than 61. They received seven calls. Police did receiving calls that alleged that he was disturbing the peace. He warned officers that his turtle army will destroy everyone.
And is there video of the army?
You know, I've
no, there's no army.
There's no army.
That sounds adorable.
There's no
I
army.
I
want to
see the turtle army.
I have
Do they have little hats on? Oh.
Kelly, I have a similar. Weirdly enough, I have a similar Florida story.
All right, well, hold on. I'm not done with this one yet.
Go ahead. No, I'm going to follow you.
Yeah, you have another one. That's crazy.
It's like, it's not verbatim, but like, you know, along the same lines. Go ahead.
he was escorted to the police station and banged on the glass before leaving. He was arrested again. Literally, you would be shot by anybody else. If you were black, you're doing all this shit.
Yeah.
you would be shot for this.
You'd have been got shot, especially in Florida.
Yeah, like for real. Like
I got
turtles.
I got an army of turtles. Put your motherfucking ass on the ground.
They would shoot at it. He was arrested again for a second time that day. Warning, you'll see what happens in an hour before making multiple claims.
That's how long it takes the turtles to get to where the cops are standing.
The slowest army in Florida.
They're right across the block. It'll be an hour. They'll be right here.
Before making
claims.
They see
claims, Batman Returns just like that.
Make multiple claims that his turtle army would avenge him. They would avenge his
death.
His yeah.
He's trained him. He's taught him kung fu.
Yeah, man. They got shells and shit like that.
Different names.
That's exactly how I feel about all you guys.
Yeah, he said they will wreak havoc on the local area as revenge for his apprehension.
You think we would avenge you?
Yo, no, the turtles.
You think me, James, and Kelly would avenge you?
No.
What's the circumstances of your life of your death?
I'm that delusional. I think y'all guys would.
Yo, what would be the circumstances of your death? Do you think that we would need to avenge you?
I figured you'd have my back no matter what.
They just have a stock photo of a turtle.
Oh yeah, I noticed that too.
And the turtle looks like, no, I ain't going. Like he was like,
he's like, I'm not in the army.
Yeah, he's like, what?
They had to use a stock photo because the guy had no turtle.
I ain't going.
No pet turtle, not even a turtle.
Man,
this is just some crazy dude
it's
fucking with the
crazy
police.
Rant.
He's just a dude in a 7-Eleven. He literally was a dude in 7-Eleven that's just cursing at people going in 7-Eleven.
He's just told, since just some redneck, they just let him rock.
Yeah, y'all fuck with the saint.
Y'all fucking with the saint.
I'm getting my turtles.
It's like a turtle is just like, uh-huh.
He's removed by force. He's removed by force. And that's
didn't
crazy.
Shoot him once.
Jesus, fuck.
No, didn't shoot him once.
They didn't shoot him not one time.
Would have been shot. We would have been already
you
shot already.
Fine. He has
just fine.
Turtle shell.
He looks he looks
put the shell on.
He looks very belligerent, for sure.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah, that's me.
Shout out to Turtle Man. You going to jail.
Paul motherfucking McCartney.
Oh.
Sir.
Sir.
Whoa.
What's
sir?
Paul
motherfucking McCartney.
Sir Paul.
He's at it again.
I forgot about this.
Ooh. Yeah, so when you have Beatles privilege, you get to do all types of crazy things.
That's a big privilege, by the way.
It's probably the best privilege there is.
It's like only... it's mad British too. Just be going to like doing shit in other cultures.
No, this is the thing. You're right.
Is it as good as Paul Simon?
Like, hold on. So when you have Beatles privilege and shit, dude, you can. Oh god. So you can be like, yo, it's Louis Armstrong's birthday. And he goes, I want to pay tribute to him. So what would be good? I'm going to play When the Saints Go Marching. Oh, really, Paul? That sounds great. Are you going to get out your fabled Hofner bass and sing and stuff with your band? No, actually, I'm not. I'm going to get a New Orleans band. Oh, that's awesome. Okay, so you're going to play bass with the... No. Oh, you're just gonna sing with them? No, I'm gonna play. I'm gonna play trumpet. And it's like,
oh, we didn't know you could play the trumpet.
We didn't know you could play trumpet. He goes, and not only am I gonna play trumpet, just any trumpet. I'm gonna play Louis Armstrong's actual trumpet.
Now wait, hold up.
And he goes, we needed some more people to fill out the band. Okay,
yes.
We need some more people to fill out the band. He goes, I think percussion would be cool. All right, let's see who we could get. How about Dave Grohl on
best
tambourine?
Percussionist
on
in
tambourine.
The world.
I think that would be great. So we have these brass band musicians, actually in New Orleans. This is all done via Zoom, kind of like how the that awesome Beach Boys COVID song was done.
Yeah.
It's got a lot in common with it.
OG.
So I know I'm setting this up a lot, but I just thought everybody should be aware of everything that's going on in here. And when you hear trumpet, oh, and there's another good trumpet player in there too.
There's a good trumpet player in there.
Oh yeah,
well, Paul's not the good one.
Hold up, well, and also, but no, but wait, Paul did play trumpet on several Beatles songs. He did play trumpet. I want to make that clear. Yes, he has played trumpet. I don't know exactly which ones, but it's on. They're on Beatles. On Beatles records.
Were there also like 12 other trumpet players playing? Listen, probably. You'll know why when you hear this. So they're gonna start. Sir Paul is doing some clapping up at the front. Just there.
Here we go.
Oh shit! This is not working. Why is this not plugged in?
Put it up in the thing.
I put it up in the thing right here.
Put it up in there. There we go.
Woo! Oh, did you hear that? That's Dave Grohl. Not on drums, just on tambourine.
It feels pretty good.
It sounds great.
It feels great. Now, who's that playing?
Sir Paul.
No.
Done.
Yo, this dude was in the Beatles.
The Beatles is so good.
Yo, man. Yo, dude, he's great, isn't he?
I saw all the comments on Facebook. Everybody loved it.
Hey, man, listen.
Except on my page.
Listen, bro. Oh, no.
Oh, no. They still got him in the mix.
Why are you doing that? When the Saints go marching in. Pro Tools is involved, people.
So listen, man. The crazy thing is this British dude is just shitting all over this the whole time.
They got Oprah singing? Is that Oprah? Who is that? Is that Viola? Who is that singing?
Paul McCartney.
Why are you leaving, Gabe? Don't leave on that joke.
Wait, hold up. Is that a... That's
Woody
that's
Allen?
Elvis Costello?
That's Mark Maron?
Is that Elvis Costello?
Yo, Elvis Costello.
That isn't Elvis. That can't be Elvis Costello.
That's Elvis Costello.
It might be.
Is it?
It might be. Like there's a couple people in there.
Oh, who's this? That's Dave Matthews?
Dave Matthews is in this.
Oh, yeah. No, Dave Matthews is doing a weird dance in this.
Yeah, he's in there. Dave Matthews is in there.
I don't like the Dave Matthews dance he's doing.
He's doing one of those.
He's like, I'm without a guitar. I need my guitar or I'm dancing weird.
Who's this asshole?
When the states come marching in.
Who are those guys?
When the states come marching in.
When the states go marching in, when the states go marching in,
when the states go marching in,
he's going to do a solo.
Let's go marching in. Why is this so long? Pause.
Why is it so long?
This is too long.
Pause.
The Roots would even only done this for 2 minutes. Like, they would do it for 2 minutes, and it would have been done.
Why is this weirdo? There's about the plastic saxophone.
Man, this is trash.
Why is this so long?
Okay. Yes.
That was way too long. Oh my God, that was like.
It's 4 minutes and 25 seconds.
How many sure choruses is that?
I'm sure that was for charity or something. So, bro, thanks, Kelly. Thank you for that.
Man, I didn't play that. You about to say thanks, Kelly?
No, I put that. I put that on my page. I was like, get your man.
I saw it right after. I saw this.
You look like you were pointing at me when you said that. You look like you about to say, get your man's, Kelly.
Nah,
like that's my man. That's not my man.
Oh my God,
that is your man.
No, that's not my.
Paul McCartney is definitely your man.
No, Paul McCartney was never in Fleetwood Mac.
It's Todd. That's Todd's man. That's Todd's man's.
He was in the Beatles, not Fleetwood Mac.
That's Todd's man's, and I didn't have to even text Todd, but I know he's probably said that, yo, that shit was fucking amazing.
You know, he loved it.
He said that shit was fucking amazing.
I got another thing with the video clip.
You know why? Because he fucking made Sgt. Pepper's, bro. That's why.
He made all,
that's it.
Oh, the Lonely Farts Club band?
Got him.